click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to study soldering, which is an allied welding process. It is welding process, but not exactly we do what we do in normal welding processes, but something related to it. So whatever things are there in soldering, we are going to see in detail. So what exactly happens in soldering? We use basically two components. Number one is your soldering gun. Second is your solder. So what you do is you join the metal, like you join the solder to any other metal, all two or three other metals, we join it together. So what happens is the gun is being provided with electrical supply. It just fires, or it just helps the arc to get stuck between the soldered part, and soldering is done. In this, filler metal plays an important role. If it is required, if not, then the whole soldering is done as it is. If filler metal is required, what filler metal do is, it has a low melting point so that it gets melted easily and get joined easily. So how it is done, we'll be seeing in the diagram. So as I have told you, there are two basic important parts. One is your soldering gun, second is your solder. I'll show you the diagrams of both. But what is a solder? It is a metallic wire which is used to join the metals, or the solder are used to be joined. What is happening exactly, we'll see now. So in this diagram, you can see a soldering gun is sewn and also a solder is sewn, which is winded. It is a form of coiled wire. So now I'll tell you about the components. These are the components which are used. As I told you, a solder and a soldering gun are a compulsory component which is used. Also, you need pliers to just hold. It is a kind of clamping device. Also, you need some electronic connections. So we'll see one by one. So in this diagram, you can see the whole arrangement of soldering is done. There is a gun, pliers are kept, and the gun is holded properly. So now how it is done, you can also see a solder, which is in the next photo. So when I talk about this gun, we can see there is a wire, electrical connection given to that gun so that proper arc can be stuck at the tip of the gun. So in this diagram, what exactly is done, we are taking a diode, normal diode. What we do is we use pliers and bend its legs, both the legs, which can be shown in the picture which is there on our slide. It is bent. Then what happens is we take a PCB, and this bent arrangement of the diode is being inserted in the PCB. So in this diagram, you can see that the wires are clearly, your diodes are clearly inserted in the PCB. On both the sides, the arrangement is different. Upper side, you can just see your wire. Lower side, you can see the arrangement, which is your legs. So soldering is done on the lower hand side. And how it is done, we'll be seeing in our next slide. So in this diagram, you can see there is a preheated soldering gun. And a solder is used. You can see a gun and a solder, both are brought near to that diode, which is inserted in your PCB on the copper side, downside. They are brought together. When the solder is touching the copper side, what happens is an arc is stuck in the electronic gun, that is your solder gun. Solder comes near to it, and the material, which is your solder, is getting melted and deposited on the copper wire, which is inserted in your PCB. So in this way, soldering is done. Also, I have told you in the starting only that the solder should have a low melting point so that it gets melted properly and get deposited on the place where it is supposed to be deposited. What happens is in the last, the solder, which is your metallic wire, is getting deposited properly on the base of the copper wire, and there is a peak-like arrangement form on that, and your exact soldering is done. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda.